Many eligible for the vaccine now are still waiting for the shot. Reporter Blake Stevens hears from a local man about the issues facing our rural communities.
Trying to get the vaccine, to me, is a complete nightmare.
It didn't start out that way for 78-year-old Dennis Armistead. A couple months ago, he was excited about getting the shot and getting on with life. Then came figuring out how to get it.
There's nothing worse than calling a number and it be busy, okay? Is it broke? They just don't answer, or I'll never get through.
When the state launched an online appointment system, he tried to sign up, but was put on a waiting list. A week later, he reached out to the state to find out his spot in line. He got this response: "Unfortunately, we are unable to offer an estimated wait time. We are unsure when we will receive more vaccine or how much we will receive until it is shipped to us from the federal government." That unknown timeline, coupled with his known health conditions, began to weigh on him.
We've known about this since October, November it's coming. Now, I don't understand why we wasn't ready for it.
He worries some friends and neighbors might give up.
Everyone here in the rural areas seems to have the same problem. They don't know where to go. You know, they don't know who to contact. The website's it's hard to navigate. So a lot of people go in that and say, the heck with it.
Persistence paid off for Dennis. He actually got his first dose a few hours ago.
Just like a flu shot, you know, I just felt a small prick. It's not even a sore yet.
A small prick, but a big relief. Blake Stevens, WATE 6, on your side.
All right, Blake, thank you. You know, the state also added correctional officers and jailers to phase 1A1 of their vaccine plan.
And people in homes with medically fragile children were moved to phase 1C.